Oh, they're squirming like crazy. Look at them go. Jeez. So they don't like light at all. Hope you stick with me and watch me hopefully not fuck this up. Mike from Green Grow Spaces here, and I am nerding out so hard right now because what I've got going on is the beginnings of my worm farm. Okay, so what you see before you here are 4 half pounds of worms. So we've got 2 pounds of red wigglers total, and here I'll show you. You can watch them wriggle around. This is exciting stuff, but yeah, they are. Oh yeah, they don't like the light. So throw them back in there. All right, and we'll make this intro real quick. So I've got my red wigglers, but I've got this massive, massive smart pot. And I think this is just a little bit too big. This is actually a 45-gallon smart pot. And it is absolutely insane. So what I'm gonna do is actually start small. I'm gonna go out to the garage. I'm gonna grab myself a 10-gallon smart pot. And I think that 2 pounds of worms should be enough to charge a worm bin that's a 10-gallon smart pot now. You can see it would take the worms, you know, a year to finish whatever I was to throw in here, so. All right, so I'll be back with the smart pot, and we're gonna get on with setting up this bin. Here we go. Worm bin and farm number 1A. So I've done a lot of research into what makes worms extremely happy while they're alive, and also what makes their poo make cannabis really happy afterwards, okay? And think of it like this, guys, because this is how I think of it, okay? Pretty much everything that you want to put into your plants mix, so whatever you want to put into your soil mix, whatever you ultimately end up want to feed your plants, you feed your worms, because the worms are going to cold process or cold compost. It's a mesophilic compost style of activity and process that happens there, and it's fantastic. It's just extremely fascinating stuff. There's among other things, what cold composting helps do is retain all of the insect repellent qualities of neem, for example, that I've got in here, right? Or it will transfer all of those 80 plus elements and all of those beneficial hormones from the kelp right over here through. It won't cook that all off. And then I've got alfalfa over here, so I've got the tricontinol and the alfalfa, guys. And then finally, this is bokashi. But what I'm primarily going to be feeding my worms is going to be malted barley. So I have organic malted barley here, guys. Yeah. And I'm going to be hitting these worms with shit ton of enzymes, okay? And there are the worms. They're last few minutes in that kind of whatever. I don't want to call it piss poor medium, but it's definitely mediocre compared to what I've got going on here. Okay, guys, I've done a lot of research into this, so. Yeah! Although I do want you to bear with me, there was a caveat to this, is this is my first worm bin, guys, so. But
I think I'm off to a good start. This right here is aged cow manure. So this is really good stuff. It doesn't even smell right now. This is really, really good stuff. I'm extremely excited. That's gonna form my base, okay? And then what I'm gonna do after that is I am going to put a bunch of, actually, the soil mix that I work with. Guys, you can see this is the soil mix that I'm working with. This is my living soil mix. There's rice hulls in here, and when the worms break that down and it degrades, I'll get silica from those rice hulls. There's a whole bunch of other stuff in this mix. There's all kinds of ingredients, so many good things that the worms are gonna love. But the reason I'm putting that mix into here as well as the composted manure, okay, is because I want the worms to get a taste for this mix when I end up pulling a bunch of them out of here and putting them in the pots, because I'm gonna expand my garden. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is, with these red wigglers, I'm gonna have a continual earthworm castings farm, and then from there, when it's time to kind of quote unquote pot up to a bigger pot, once those worms get bigger and they multiply, I'll take some of those worms and I'll end up putting them actually in the pots that I grow my cannabis in. And I've had great results doing that so far, pulling worms from my yard. So here we go. I know that these red wigglers are gonna do awesome. All right, so the idea is, again, they love consistency, and they're gonna love the soil once they get into it because they've already had a nice taste of it here. All right, guys, so I've got that there. Here we've got neem. You can see I've already got that in there. We went over the malted barley. There's a bunch of reasons why I want to use this, and we'll hit on all those in another episode for sure, guys. But I know I need to breathe. Ah, you guys are probably like, Mike, breathe. Yeah, I'm gonna breathe. Okay, and then anyways, moving all along here, we've got all this stuff. And then finally, the last thing I'm gonna put in is gonna be a dose of microbes. Even though there is already a fair amount of microbes in this manure, I'm gonna be using the microbes from here as well, just to add a few more. Among other places and outlets, I've done a lot of research on YouTube. How to set up a worm farm, how to vermicompost this, vermicompost that, vermiculture, yada, yada, yada. All these things. And you know, a lot of them, they give out a lot of good tips, but there's a few things that I've noticed that I missed. I didn't hear anyone say anything about the soil from their backyard and the grit that these worms need. Now, I've heard people mention grit, and you can get that from eggshells, you can get that from a bunch of other things, but I haven't heard when they do say you can go get soil, but I'd be careful, because unless it's, you know, your backyard and your backyard alone, and you know your neighbors aren't using pesticides and that's not leaching over into your yard for sure, 100% you know that that's not the case, then go ahead and use that soil. But again, I'm using compost. If you use aged compost, then make sure it's aged, because you do want all of those vermicides. Those are like the toxins that kill the worms in the guts of the cow. The farmers take care of their cows' guts and the insides of their intestines and the worms with vermicides. So if you age your manure, then you deconstruct those vermicides and you make it, you know, basically, you render it useful for the worms. So I've done a whole shitload of talking, but you haven't seen any action yet. So let's get to the action, because there's gonna be a fair amount of wriggling. And then while I'm mixing this, if I think of anything else useful that I wanna blurt out, I'll blurt it out. But in the meantime, guys, enjoy the tunes, and let's do this. Jeez. So they don't like light at all. Alright, so in conclusion, this. definitely, there's some puddling now of all that juice. That is really, really, really good stuff right now. But once it turns into that worm juice, well, I mean, I've read mixed review, guys. So I wouldn't be drinking worm juice anytime soon until I see someone else do it and turn into the Incredible Hulk. I was wondering what to cover it with. I thought to myself, Jesus, should I cover it with plastic? Should I cover it with this? How do you even cover something like this? And I've got a really lightweight filter, guys. So I am going to cover this pot with this filter, and We're done.
They don't like the light, and they're also camera shy. It's still early on. They don't have much YouTube experience yet. Give them another little bit, but they're moving down. So I need to hit them with some water now, guys. This is probably the last time I'm gonna see all these worms squirming around like this at the top of the surface. For quite some time anyway. Hopefully they don't die.